माय सेम इज तेजश्री गोसले, लेक्चरर फ्रॉम प्रवीण पाटिल पॉलिटेक्निक भाईंदर। माय सब्जेक्ट इज मेंटेनेंस ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल इक्विपमेंट। इन दिस चैप्टर 4 इज टेस्टिंग एंड ट्रबल शूटिंग ऑफ ट्रांसफार्मर्स पार्ट 3। लर्निंग आउटकम्स। एट द एंड ऑफ दिस वीडियो यू विल लर्न अबाउट न्यूमेरिकल्स ऑन ओपन सर्किट एंड शॉर्ट सर्किट टेस्ट। सो फर्स्ट न्यूमेरिकल, अ 110 kVA सिंगल फेज ट्रांसफार्मर हैज अ रेशियो ऑफ 1100 अपॉन 440 वोल्ट। द वैट मीटर रीडिंग ऑन OC टेस्ट इज 1100 वैट। इफ द सेकेंडरी वाइंडिंग शॉर्ट सर्किट अ वोल्टेज ऑफ 500 वोल्ट एट नॉर्मल फ्रिक्वेंसी अप्लाइड टू प्राइमरी प्रोड्यूसेस फुल लोड करंट, द वैट मीटर इज 1000 वैट। कैलकुलेट फर्स्ट सेकेंडरी वोल्टेज, सेकेंड इफिशियंसी। When current of 250 ampere at lagging power factor is taken by a load connected to low voltage terminal, the primary voltage being 1100 volt. So first, to calculate full load current, IFL is equal to KVA into 10 raised to 3 upon V1. This is the formula to calculate full load current. So first calculate full load current. So IFL is equal to 110 into 10 raised to 3 upon 1100. So IFL becomes 100 ampere. Next, you have to calculate secondary terminal voltage. So V2 is equal to 440 volt. Cos phi is 0.8. Sin phi is 0.6. Secondary terminal voltage formula is root 2 V2 cos phi plus R0 to I2 square plus V2 sin phi plus I2 x0 to bracket square. So V2 is equal to 440 volt. I2 is equal to kVA into 10 raised to 3 upon V2. So IFL is equal to 110 into 10 raised to 3 upon 440. So I2 is equal to 250 ampere. Next, third is to calculate resistance and reactance. So in this image you can see there is a voltage, that is 1100 primary side and for secondary 440 volt. So to find copper losses, full load copper losses, formula is IFL to R01. So R01 is equal to 1000 upon 100 bracket square. So R01 is equal to 0.1 ohm. Next is Z01. So Z01 is equal to VSC upon ISC. So Z01 is equal to 500 upon 100. So Z01 becomes 5 ohm. Next you have to calculate X01 and formula is root of Z01 square minus R01 square is equal to root of 5 square minus 0.1 square. So X01 becomes 4.9989 ohm. And we need R02 and X02 for calculations. So K becomes V2 upon V1 is equal to 440 upon 1100 is equal to 0.4. So R02 is equal to K square into R01 and R02 is equal to 0.4 square into 0.1. So value of K is 0.4 and R01 is 0.1. So R02 becomes 0.016 ohm. Next, you have to calculate X02. So, X02 formula is K square into X01. So, put these values in this equation. So, X02 becomes 0.4 bracket square into 4.9989. So, value is 0.7998 ohm. Next, you have to calculate secondary terminal voltage. So, formula is root of V2 cos phi plus R02 I2 bracket square plus V2 sin phi plus I2 X02 bracket square. So second terminal voltage becomes root of 440 into 0.8 plus 0.016 into 250 bracket square plus 440 into 0.6 plus 0.7998 into 250 bracket square. So second terminal voltage becomes 584.7953 volts. Next, you have to calculate efficiency at 0.8 power factor lagging and full load. So for that, you have to first calculate output in power. So output in power is equal to kVA into power factor is equal to 110 into 0.8. So it becomes 88 kilowatt. Next, total losses in kilowatt. So WI plus WCU, that is iron loss plus copper loss. So 1100 plus 1000. So it becomes 2100 watt. Next, losses in kilowatt becomes 2100 upon 1000, which becomes 2.1 kilowatt. And next, you have to calculate the efficiency, and formula is output power upon output power plus total losses into 100. So efficiency becomes 88 upon 88 plus 2.1 into 100, which is 97.66%. Next numerical is, following test results were obtained in a single phase 2.75 kVA 250 by 125 volt transformer on a short circuit test with S1 and S2 shorted, conducted at test temperature of 30 degree Celsius, current 8 ampere, voltage applied 36 volt, power is equal to 128 watts. Find first percentage resistance and second percentage impedance, both at 75 degree Celsius. So given data becomes, single phase 2.75 kVA transformer 250 by 125 volts, VAC is 36 volt, ISC 8 ampere, WSC 128 watt. So solution, so first you have to calculate resistance at 30 degree Celsius. So for that, you have to calculate first WSC is equal to ISC square into R01. This is formula, and from that you can calculate R01. So R01 at 30 degree Celsius is equal to WSC upon ISC square is equal to 128 upon 8 square. So R01 at 30 degree Celsius becomes 2 ohm. Next, you have to calculate Z01. So Z01 formula is VSC upon ISC, which is equal to 36 upon 8 is equal to 4.5 ohm. Next, you can calculate from this X01. So X01 is equal to root of Z01 bracket square minus R01 bracket square, so which is equal to 4.5 square minus 2 square, which is equal to 4.0311 ohm. So X01 value is 4.0311 ohm. Next, you have to calculate resistance at 75 degree Celsius. So formula for that is R2 by R1 is equal to T2 plus 234.5 upon T1 plus 234.5. So therefore, R01 at 75 degree Celsius is equal to R at 30 degree Celsius into 234.5 plus 75 upon 234.5 plus 30. Therefore, R at 75 degree Celsius becomes 2.3402 ohm. So there will be no effect on inductive reactance. The value of inductive reactance will be remain the same. Therefore, X01 at 75 degree Celsius is equal to X01 at 30 degree Celsius is equal to 4.0311 ohm. Next, we have to calculate impedance at 75 degree Celsius. So formula is, therefore, Z01 at 75 degree Celsius is equal to root of R01 at 75 degree Celsius bracket square plus X01 at 75 degree Celsius bracket square. So Z01 at 75 degree Celsius is equal to root of 2.3402 bracket square plus 4.0311 bracket square. So therefore, Z01 at 75 degree Celsius becomes 4.6611 ohm. Thank you.